like to welcome you all to Gate City Baptist Church. Tonight, we are gathered to worship Christ, so we welcome him here too. But don't think that you're just here for a performance, though. This is an occasion to exalt Emmanuel, God with us. If you know the songs, feel free to lift your voices in worship along with the choir at any point during the evening. As you listen to other songs that you might not know, please lift your hearts in worship. And if you don't yet know this Savior we celebrate, you're invited to consider his good news for you tonight. Now, please join us as we sing. Yes, God is with us because of Christmas. It's time to celebrate Emmanuel. It's time to embrace the infectious joy that happens this time of year. And there's nothing that puts us in the Christmas spirit quicker than singing our favorite carols. So let's all stand and sing a few of the songs of Christmas.
Joy to the world, O Lord,
Awesome. Thank you. You can be seated.
There were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said, "Fear not, for behold, I bring good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people.
For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And it shall be a sign to you, you shall find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, laying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, good will towards men."
By his mother's side, he here lay the Savior inside a manger.
Told everyone inside.
It was a glorious night, a night that would change everything. Let your imagination wander back to a simpler time in history, before electricity or running water, long before there were automobiles, telephones, or computers. Picture a tiny village. It's nighttime, and the air is cold and damp. A young man and his teenage wife have walked some 70 miles to reach this small village. Tired and weary, they are in need of a place to stay for the evening. But when they reach the town, it is already overrun with travelers. Every room has been taken. Can you see them as they stand outside the innkeeper's door? The young girl is very close to giving birth to her first child. She's needing a place of warmth, a safe place to sleep. A stable where animals are sheltered ends up being the only place offered to them. I can see the young man gathering hay to create a makeshift bed for his precious bride, when suddenly It is time for her baby to be born. Yes, love was born in Bethlehem. Love like mankind had never known. Love that would soon transform the world. But on the night that Jesus was born, there were very few who knew his true identity. Mary, Joseph, a band of shepherds, a very small group of people. Yet all of the inhabitants of heaven knew exactly who he was. And soon the world would realize who that manger really held.
Source, the end, divine.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. So many names attributed to this child born in Bethlehem. But Mary and Joseph were not instructed to call this holy child by any of those majestic names. The angel of the Lord was very clear as to the earthly name this infant king should be called.
You were the Word at the beginning, one with God, the Lord Most High. Your hidden glory in creation, now revealed in you, our Christ. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name. Jesus, you brought heaven down. My sin was great, your love was greater. What could separate us now? What a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name. Christ my King. What a wonderful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus.
What a powerful name.
In recent years, many have tried to reduce this sacred and blessed event we know as Christmas to a mere holiday for lavishing gifts on one another and on ourselves. But Christmas isn't just another vacation day on the calendar. The birth of Jesus Christ, God's only begotten Son, makes Christmas a holy day. A day for celebrating and rejoicing, for sure, but also a day of solemn worship and humble thanksgiving. A time for us to give honor and praise to the one who came to save us from our sin, who came to offer us freedom and hope. It's a time to remember the best news of Christmas.
Jesus saves.
You know, for many, this season truly is the most wonderful time of the year. The very thought of it stirs up all kinds of warm and gushy feelings. And part of each and every Christmas is all the memories we hold precious and dear from holidays past. But so much more valuable than those sweet holiday moments is the remembrance of our Savior who came from heaven and changed the world. As we retell the story of the birth of Jesus, we are reminded of the angels who proclaimed glad tidings of great joy. We remember Mary and Joseph as they sought shelter in Bethlehem, shepherds, wise men, Simeon, King Herod, all the characters who took part in the wondrous event we call Christmas. In the midst of remembering that glorious night of miracles, we have good reason to rejoice, because Jesus Christ, God's Son, came seeking you and me. He came to love, heal, and forgive. The King of Kings came to be the light of the world, the light for each of us. Once we realize who He really is, we can't help but worship Him and offer Him our lives.
Star in manger, he
Looking back at the Christmas story, we find that every person who encountered this holy child worshiped him. We are in good company when we blend our hearts together and worship at Christmas, for we find ourselves among the angels and the shepherds and the wise men, all who praised and worshiped this child named Jesus. And in a sense, the story of Christmas is still being written. For when we bow our knee before the Lord and receive him as our personal Savior, we become part of the Christmas story. Christmas becomes more than just a story or a holiday memory. It becomes the reminder that we've been forgiven of our sins and have received the real gift of Christmas, which is eternal life. We no longer simply remember that Jesus came in history, because now we know him, not just as a babe in Bethlehem, but as our Savior and our Lord, not just born in a stable, but born in us.
Here's
Jesus King, the Lord of glory, the one who was born in Bethlehem for us, the one who died and rose from the dead, the one who is still changing lives today. Someday he'll leave his heavenly throne one more time. King Jesus will come to earth to take his children home to be with him forever and ever, and there we'll gather around him in worship. And until then, on Christmas Day, and on every day, we will worship.
Deeper peace than this. choir. That was a wonderful job. Didn't they do a wonderful job? I want to thank, first of all, Karen, thank you for all the hard work and time you've put into this. And choir, thank you for all the hard work and time. And Calvin, especially you for wearing that red sweater. You look so good. Thank all of our children and our students. And Miss Beth, didn't the students and children do a good job tonight? I thought they did great. And then you got some folks back in the back that you can't see, but there are people running the video and sound, and a lot goes into this, folks. And so just thank everybody that was involved. Thank you, Dallas, for carrying out these blocks a while ago. You did a great job at that, and Drew and Devin. But so much goes into this. And, you know, I hate to speak on behalf of the choir and Karen, but I'm going to, all right? Can I do that? Is that okay with you guys? Can I speak on your behalf? They didn't do this to be applauded. I'm glad we did applaud your efforts, but this is not for us to be entertained and for you guys to entertain us and then us applaud you. That's not why we do this. Because you can be entertained pretty much anywhere, right? Go to a movie tonight, you can be entertained. The purpose for tonight, I believe, is twofold. It's for believers to have the opportunity to worship the living God, to worship Jesus, who came to this earth and lived a perfect life and was crucified on a cross, became our sin, according to Peter, and then was laid in a borrowed tomb and was raised from the dead. That's what we had the opportunity to do tonight. So thank you for allowing us to worship the living Lord tonight. I believe that's why you did this, right? Not so that you could hear good job or even be applauded. That's not what you're into this for. You're doing this so that we can all worship the living Lord. But there's a second reason I believe you did this, isn't it? It's because maybe somebody out here doesn't know Jesus as their Savior. And we're so thankful that you're here. But maybe tonight you're here and you know about Jesus, you know why we celebrate Christmas, but you don't know Christ in a personal way, in a real way. The choir did this tonight so that they could present the truth, the gospel to you through song, and you've heard the truth. Jesus is the Savior of the world, and he still stands ready to save you tonight. And so since you guys did share truth with us, I believe anytime truth is shared that we need an opportunity to respond to that truth. And so instead of doing a normal invitation like we do in the Baptist church where somebody plays music and somebody like me stands down front, or Michael, I want you to respond this way. I was thinking back there, and this is what the Lord laid on my heart. If you're here tonight, and if you're visiting with us, or if you're here tonight and you're a member, whatever, and you want to respond to the truth that you've experienced tonight, I want to ask you to do me this favor. Would you fill out one of these connection cards? You just write your name down. And then on the back, it says, is there anything you would want us to join you in praying about? You can fill that. You can fill that out. You can fill out all the information if you want to. And here's what I'll do. I'll make sure that these cards are prayed over. I bet the choir would love the opportunity to pray for people that were here tonight, wouldn't you? So how about this? At the next choir practice, before you do anything else, you'll pray for the people that fill out these cards. Will you guys do that? So the choir just said that they'll pray for you. So if you're a member, if you're a guest, if you don't know the Lord, we want to pray for you. We want to pray that you'll come to know Christ in a personal way. You can even fill out on here, hey, I want somebody to contact me or come see me to share more about Jesus. And we'll do that. So whatever your prayer need is, if you just fill out this card, write your name on it. Now, how many? We got some deacons here tonight. Where's our deacons at? Raise your hand if you're a deacon. I need for a couple of deacons. I need somebody to stand at that door. Somebody to stand at that door. All the exits. I need three deacons at least. You can go ahead and go there now. And our deacons are going to be there because they care about you, and they're here to serve the Lord, and they're going to take these cards. So just hand it to one of our deacons. And guys, if everybody would eventually get your cards to Jim over here, Jim Dunlap, and Jim, you get the cards to me, okay? So fill these out. We want to know how we can pray for you, all right? Let's close with a word of prayer. Lord, thank you so much for the opportunity to be here. And thank you, Lord, for how tonight the truth of the gospel was shared to us through song. And Lord, I thank you for Karen. I thank you for the choir. I thank you for everyone that was involved here tonight. But most of all, I just want to thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Thank you for being my Savior. Thank you for allowing me to come here tonight and worship the Savior of my life. Lord, I do pray if there's someone here tonight who does not know Jesus Christ in a real way, in a personal way, I pray that tonight Lord, that they would come to know you, that they would place their faith in you so that they can be set free forever. Lord, I'd pray also that if there's somebody here tonight that has a prayer need, Lord, whatever it is, I pray that they'd just take the time now just to fill out one of these cards. And Father, I Lord, look forward to the opportunity to praying over these cards. I know that our choir does as well. And I pray all of this in the powerful name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Now, there's a fellowship, right? There's refreshments in the fellowship hall. So if you're hungry, you better run over there, right? Refreshments in the fellowship hall. Good night. God bless.